So you should hold on to the lower hands, I guess, just from right here. I want you to do the forward forehand, like here, and then bring it over here and go low backhand. That's it. Just do forehand and low backhand. And again, forehand and low backhand. And we're going to do forehand and low backhand. Just like this, okay? Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's important. When you do this, bring it over here, go down. Here, over to the side, and come down. Okay? Very good. Now, you just learned the first drill. This is not hard. Everybody pick up your sticks real quick. Okay. Now, in our class, we pay respect to each other. So you'll see Jack and I bow like this. Guys, y'all don't need to or anything like that. It's just us. But anyhow, when you're holding your stick, you want to not extend your fingers down the stick or your thumb. Take your thumb and wrap it around like that and I'll hold the stick in. And you're going to have basically a little bit of a punya, what we call punya, or the butt of the stick, okay? Hanging out. You do not want to be like this because this gives up reach. If I remember with Jackie, and I can get her here, if I sit there and I choke up, you see where I miss. This can be the difference if somebody's striking at me and I'm trying to strike at them between me getting hit and me missing her. So try and, you know, just give yourself a little bit of a punyo, a little bit of the butt of the stick, but then that's it. We use this for hitting and striking, and you can learn all that from Robert later on. But for right now, what we're going to do is this. We're just going to do single single wall. I want you to simply take one foot, go to your front, come across, and down. Here. Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Get across to your partner and try that out. Alright? Good. Now, hold on, everybody. Get this up real quick. Hold on. Look. Real quick. Look, don't stand here like this and just kind of stand here. Okay? If you're going to stand in a position, standing basically, this is our first mode, first stance, it's forward stance. Okay? Just one foot forward right here as opposed to standing flat footed. Okay? Now, if you're needing the sticks, of course, stand here like this and just get used to it. A little bit more. Here, start adding footwork, but all that's beyond us. We're focusing today, we're focusing on the way things connect together. So it's the hands that I'm worried about right now. Can we do this? So what you're going to do now is we're going to connect the double sticks to the hip again. Okay? So we're going to be here like this, hands up. Now one of the important things is that we don't let our hands drop down here. Let's call this having a dead hand. Okay, you wouldn't spar, when you spar, you got your hands up here like this, or however, you would not be sitting there keeping your hands down. I want your hands up. And what we're doing is we're tying the three drills we just did together. We start off first with empty hands and wall, just the basic pattern. We're going to hit here and hit down. Turn. Hit here and hit down. This is very easy. Okay? Then you can go here to here to here. Okay? You can switch between the two patterns. You go here, there you go, see? Okay? And then it dissolves. And that's okay, so you can just see your hands might not see the videos. Do that for a few minutes, and then we'll show you where we're going from there. Can we do this?
Sure.
Quickly, everybody switch partners. All right, bow your knee partners and go. Now, we've just been doing the adding in the punch, okay? And again, this is where in class, you would really sit there and work on proper body mechanics and things like that. I'm trying to give you a brief overview on how things connect. And that's really the purpose for today. It is not content mastery, okay? Or skill mastery, okay? Everybody kind of understand what I mean, all right? The purpose today really is to show you how things connect and how we use the drill so that you can kind of understand, in a sense, the way the Filipino martial arts are trained, or, you know, the crisis systems, as they were taught to us, were trained, okay? Now, we can be here, we can use this single cinnamon like this, and we throw in the punch and stuff. But, see, you can also use single cinnamon to come in into lock, okay? As you come on back, as we connect here like this, this is what was called full finger lock. Bring this on up here, you can transition into two finger lock, you can turn it into over the shoulder pick downs, such like this, okay? And we're not going into locking right now because locking, friend, is a really higher level skill, okay? You need to be able to hit first, bottom line. But you can do that for a lot of me, being here like this. And I can pass and come into lock. So I can use this in a lot of drills to start working and passing. And do this for chokes and for takedowns and things. Okay? You understand what I'm saying? So the drills are much deeper than you think. It's kind of like, if you think about an iceberg, whatever you see above the top is only like 10%. There's 90% of that thing underneath. Okay? And it's the same way here with these types of drills. And so I just wanted to kind of show you how these things interrelate. We're in here like this. Later on, we'll start doing tracking skills where I'm in here. And the thing is that if somebody reaches for me, I grab and I hit. Then I can do whatever I want to and such, okay? You understand what I mean? Whatever I put on the end of that is my creation. That's what floats me. I mean, you know, that is what, as Grandmaster Arnis calls, you know, you add your own gingerbread, you add your own specialty to the mix, to the recipe. The drill is just the foundation, okay? But the goal of it is you can use a simple drill to once again, augment the teaching on locking. You know? So what we're going to do here, now it's the same thing with weapons. If you go ahead and pick up too much. We're out here with this, and I can use this to come in and kick in and practice my weapon. You know, you understand what I mean? We started off with this little drill. But then I use that motion from single cinnamon advance. Here, to come in. You know, if she sits there and she goes to hit, I can back and take her down. Okay? You know, it's just, you know, different ways of doing things. We can use this to pass, or other like that, I'm sorry. Other like this, we double the ball, we're doing it. It's the same drill pattern. But what are we now doing? We're practicing double blocks. So that's what we're going to next practice here, real quick. Now we're going to use the backhand strike from single cinnamon advance. Alright? So we're here, single cinnamon advance. I'm sorry, right here. I want you to do single cinnamon. But where last time we had the feeder punch, now the feeder's going to feed the back hand. And she blocks with both hands. Everybody understand? Now back. But what am I doing here? I am striking in here hard so she learns how to block on the outside of that hand. If if I was coming in with a weapon, see, she wants to be out here on the outside of my arm. Can you stop this? If I'm coming in with two hands, like a baseball bat, same thing. She wants to be on the outside. Okay? And she stops it. So, what I want you all to do is we're going to do this, but you're going to feed in the back end first. Can we do this? Everybody? Okay. So now instead of it, we're only going to do this for a few minutes, okay? What I'm trying to do is show you how we tie the techniques together, okay? And then we're going to get into the defensive responses here next, and we'll tie all that together into this so that everybody gets an idea. Can we do this? So what we're going to do is we're going to just slightly augment this a little bit, okay? When she's coming in here feeding like this, so she feeds back in with her left, okay? If she feeds that left, I want to angle in to here. Don't just practice this and stand here like this. I want to angle in here like here, okay? Because this then leads into whatever I want to, you know, do later on. Can we, that's number one. Number two, I want you to, as we're doing this, she comes in here, here. Okay? Now, the reason for this is because if the person's coming in with a weapon, I want to move in. Okay? I don't want to be out here at the edge. If she's got a stick here, she's got a stick. I don't want to be out here. This is where I get hit, so I don't want to stand here like this. I want to practice watching the body language of that hand come across and move in. So as this comes, I move in. Well, then I want to attack. And if I can start breaking her balance here, alright, to rock her world with a good strike up there to the head, then whatever I want to do, then, you know, it's up to me. I have my own, whatever I want to do. So I want you to train to do this here, pop to the head. Can we do that real quick? Alright? Yeah, be careful if you got glasses on. And don't thumb me off.